when I look for words which are searched the most, do you know the word which is searched the most is happiness? And it's interesting that we are going to Google to check happiness. Second word used the most on Google is relationships. Another word used more is parenting. And one more very important word, which is searched often on Google, is depression. Now, these are words about which we can get technical information, that this is what happiness is, this is what relationship is supposed to be. But the internet will not be able to give us the knowledge and the understanding of our own emotional state and how to be happy and how to create beautiful relationships and definitely not go towards a depression. So for that, we need to shift from the outer world and take a moment and go and check the inner world. And the answer for that will not be given by anyone outside. There's only one and only one person who knows the quality of my inner world. Because my inner world is not what the world can see. How I speak, how I behave is not my inner world. My inner world is what's going on here. And there's only one person who knows. There's only one person who knows how's my inner world today. And where's that one person? Who's that one person? Myself. But myself should take out a little time to check. Because it's only myself that can check, and it's only I who can change. It's only I who can take charge. And it's only I who have control. Nothing and no one outside will be able to help me for it. So let's take a moment of silence and ask yourself a simple question which you ask many people during the day. How are you? Ask yourself, how are you today? How many of us can experience absolute calm and peace throughout the day? Absolute calm and stillness and peace, because that's the natural health of a mind. That's the natural state of a mind. That's how the mind is supposed to be. Still, calm, peaceful, in charge, powerful, untouched. Untouched and unaffected, creating and influencing the world, not getting affected by the world. That's the natural health of the mind. How many of us experience this the entire day? Once in a while. Because what's natural to me, even if I can't experience it the entire day, at least I will need to check how much part of the day can I experience that. And then shift from it being once in a while to being that way throughout the day. The natural state of the mind is to be calm and peaceful and create the right thought required for every situation. Calm and peaceful does not mean sitting in meditation. Calm and peaceful means being calm even if there is a crisis outside. Being stable even if there is an absolute chaos outside. Responding right even if everyone outside is being wrong to me. That's the natural state of the mind. And that is called perfect emotional health. And since your country is number one on physical health, all the more reason that let's be number one on emotional health. No, not mental health. We're not even talking about mental health here. This is not mental health. This is emotional health. Mental health is going to go towards depression and the list. Because if we talk about mental health, many of us are going to say, no, I'm perfect. Nothing wrong with me. And that's very good. But we are checking emotional health. On a grading of 1 to 10. 1 to 10. 10, perfect emotional health. 1, please rank yourself. 1 to 10. Rank yourself. Now, if the hole could give us lights, it would be easier to see. But even then, please raise your hands. Number 10. 9. 8. 7. 6. 5. Maximum hands always come for 5. 4. 4. 3. 2. 1. Nothing less than that. We wouldn't be sitting here if we were less than that. Now ask yourself, why have you given yourself this grading? On the basis of what? What was the criteria for giving yourself 9, 8, 7? Because nobody raised their hand for 10. So what's the reason? On what basis did you say, I am 9 or I am 8 or I am 7 or 6? And it doesn't matter what figure you raised your hand at. Each one of us has the power to raise our hand for 10. And it will happen tomorrow itself. Because that's our natural health. But what's the criteria? Why did we say I am 9 or 8 or 7? Why? What were the reasons? What made you say that I am not in my perfect 10 emotional health? Reason. Hanji? We get carried away. Very good. Carried away by? By? We get carried away by the surroundings. And when we get carried away by the surroundings, what happens? Our mind gets disturbed. Anyone else here gets disturbed because of the surrounding? Good. So at least now we're very clear what is emotional health. Which means 10 emotional health means my emotions are not dependent on the surrounding. 9 emotional health means once in a while I get affected by the surrounding, and then go up to 1. 1 means I get affected even if somebody does not like my post on social media, I get disturbed. That's 1. That's 1. Which means I need nothing to get disturbed, just 1 small thing and I can get disturbed. Anything which is not my way. Anything which is not my way in the outside world, in my surroundings, and surroundings could be my family, surrounding could be my friends, surroundings could be my workplace, anything, surrounding could be the weather. Since the time I've come to Europe, every day people say, oh, it's very hot, it's very hot. It's affecting here. Let it only affect here. Hot is uncomfortable for the body. Agreed. We're not used to that kind of a weather, and suddenly we're experiencing a weather which we've not used to. That's okay. So the body can be uncomfortable. The mind can be calm and stable. Difference. Difference. So where is the surrounding affected? And where is the surrounding not supposed to touch? Because the surrounding will not be my way always. People will not be my way. Weather will not be my way. Traffic will not be my way. My spouse will not be my way. My children will not be my way. My neighbor will not be my way. A person I trusted completely tomorrow will not be my way. They will not. And it's fine. They are not supposed to be my way. But if I said it's normal that my mind is dependent on the surrounding, then every time my surrounding is not my way, what happens to my inner world? What happens to my inner world? It gets affected. And when it got affected, we said this was normal. And because we said it's normal to get affected by the outer world, we allowed our mind to keep getting affected by the outer world. But innately we wanted to be happy. So we requested the outer world to be perfect. Have you ever asked your outer world to be perfect? Please change so that I can be happy. Please talk like this so that I can be happy. Please sit like this so that I'm more comfortable seeing you that way. We keep asking the outer world to be our way. Now see, I've asked 3 times for the light in the hall. They are not giving it to me. This is the outer world. They don't listen to me. But they have a reason for what they are doing. But if I believe that my happiness is now dependent on the light being perfect, then I am now going to get disturbed. And when I get disturbed and upset and irritated, I don't even realize that it's I who's creating that disturbance. I just said, they did not do what I asked them to do, so? What's the next line? So? Very beautiful. Not my fault, I got disturbed. So whose fault? Their fault. So who needs to change? They need to change. They looked at me and said the same. They looked at me and they said the same, that I am also disturbed because you're not ready to change. So we put our fingers on other people and said, because of you, I am disturbed. And they said, no problem, I am also disturbed because of you. And then gradually, we accepted this disturbance as a part of our life. We accepted that to get upset is normal, to get angry is normal, to get irritated is normal, to get hurt is normal. Today people are saying depression, normal. We started accepting it, and that's when it became very risky, that we started accepting it. Because when we start accepting something, we don't change. We don't change. And then the result is, we're very rich, we're also very healthy, but not sure how happy we are throughout the day. And we don't want to be successful only in the outer world, we also want to be a successful person in our inner world. Imagine one word by somebody and my mind goes. How many people do you think have the remote control to the state of your mind? They can press one button and we go. And then they press another button and we go. Somebody has to just say, you're looking so pretty, and we go. Next line, they have to say, you've put on a little weight. There we go. So one word from people around us and we can go high and we can go low, which means my emotional state becomes dependent on. And people walked into our lives. They said what they believed was right. They did what they believed was right. And because we believed that they have the remote control of our life, we were not able to be happy always. We were not able to be happy always. And then we said, it's because of them. It's because of them. Can we take personal guarantee of people's behaviors? Can we take personal guarantee of other people's behaviors? They will always be like, no. Can we take personal guarantee of our responses? Can we take personal responsibility of our responses? Two worlds, right? Outer world and my inner world. Outer world, I can't take guarantee. I don't know how they will behave tomorrow. Right? Can I take a guarantee? Let them behave however they want tomorrow. I will be peaceful. Who's ready to take personal guarantee of their response? Kya hua? Mushkil kya hai? They will behave their way. I may want them to behave a certain way, but they will not behave my way. Whose way will they behave? They will behave their way. Is it okay if they behave their way, or are they supposed to behave my way? Because my way is the right way. Yeah. So because my way is the right way, they should behave my way. I may advise them to behave that way. They may not, but still not behave that way. Can I take a guarantee that they will behave my way? No. Can I take a guarantee that I will respond my way? Certain? Certain? But they can behave any way on tomorrow. Then don't say, I thought they will be a little different, but I didn't think they will do this. This is unexpected, absolutely. When we are saying an uncertain world means what life has to offer to me is not certain anymore. It's not certain anymore. So there is an element of uncertainty outside. There are only two ways to be happy. Please check the equation and fit the one which you believe is right. Only two ways to be happy. One, if the world is my way, I'll be happy always. Second, if I respond right my way, then also I can be happy always. Which one is possible? Second one. So why not put a little effort there? We've been putting so much of effort in trying to make them our way. We make a lot of effort in trying to make people our way, situations our way. They haven't changed because they don't want to change, because they are very comfortable being their way. And everyone should be the way they believe is right. We can suggest, we can advise, we cannot force people to change. And even if we force people to change, we cannot change them. We can only force them. And the more you force them and the more they don't change, the more the frustration increases. So let's tell our mind once and for all today, I cannot change people. Bol do acche se. I cannot change people. Acche se, feel it. See them. See what you're trying to change in them. And tell yourself, I cannot change people. Sure? I can try. I can advise. I can suggest. I can instruct. I can order, I can force, I cannot change. Who can change them? Who can change them? They themselves. When will they change themselves? When they want. That's what is very important. When they want. And till then, what am I going to do? They will change when they want. And when will they change? When they believe they want to change. And till then, what's going to be my state of mind? Till then, I can just shift to change the one on whom I have total control. What we did was, we thought changing people is very easy. And for ourselves, we said, mind is not at all in my control. I can control other people's mind, but when it comes to my mind, I don't have control over my mind. So the equation went wrong. Where there was no control, we thought we have control. And where there was control, I said, I have no control.